Hey, what's going on, guys? Eric here, back with another video for y'all. And in today's really quick video, I want to answer a question that I get quite a bit, especially from clients and customers that take statin drugs, cholesterol-lowering medication, basically. And the side effect is the lowering of a really important enzyme called coenzyme Q10, right? So the question that I get a lot is when I walk into a GNC or a vitamin shop, or, you know, ordering supplements online, what should I really be looking for? Which one should I buy? Ubiquinol or CoQ10? And what are they, and what is the difference? So ubiquinol, in short, is the more active and the more bioavailable form of CoQ10, which is why it's, in my personal opinion, better to take, but it's also a little bit more expensive. It's not the cheapest product in the world, but really where it all starts is, what is CoQ10? So CoQ10 is a coenzyme that basically helps our body convert. It helps every cell in our body convert the food that we eat, our fatty acids, the amino acids, the carbohydrates, takes all that, and it helps our body convert all that into readily available energy, aka ATP, or adenosine triphosphate. Now, we use ATP for a lot of different uses in the body. And CoQ10 is held in our brain, it's held in our heart, it's held in a lot of different organs around our body, helping up to power up all those organs and helping them function properly. So the issue is as we get older, our bodies naturally lower the amount of CoQ10 that we actually produce. That's why when we get older, it's one of the reasons why when we get older, we start to think slower. Right? We start to have muscular pain. We start to have heart issues, blood pressure issues. We start to lose that mind-muscle connection that we love so much in fitness, right? We lose a little bit more control over our bodies per se. And that's a shitty feeling. I mean, that's basically called being tired and moody all day long. And it's even worse for clients and customers that are taking statin drugs. You know, because high cholesterol is a really common thing, especially for a lot of older women and a lot of older men. And when you take those drugs, the side effect is it just completely zaps all the CoQ10 right out of your body. And that is a completely super shitty feeling that a lot of people really shouldn't have to go through. You know, your view on life like starts to suck. Like, you know, what something means to you, it's just a lot harder. I mean, getting up, getting out of bed is even hard when you have a low amount of CoQ10 in your body. So that's why when you're able to replenish the amount of CoQ10, or in my personal preference, ubiquinol, the more active form, you start to get better brain function back, right? You start to get better muscle contractions. You have more control over your body. It's the type of energy that's not per se, it's not like drinking, you know, a pre-workout or an energy drink. It's the type of longevity energy that you don't crash from. You just have an overall better vitality. And there's a bunch of different positives with better, more CoQ10 in the body, or a sufficient amount that we're supposed to produce. It's good for fertility, good for overall energy, for brain functions, good for athletic performance as well, because we're able to generate more ATP for explosiveness. It's good for blood pressure and just a whole host of other things that I'll list down below. But it's a really important coenzyme that I think a lot of us really should be looking into, and that you should be aware of. You know, a lot of young guys and young girls really don't have to worry about it too much, but if you do want to supplement with it, I suggest looking, like, if you're younger, by all means go for CoQ10. But if you're an older gentleman or an older female, and especially if you are on statin drugs and you really start to feel the side effects of your statin drugs, of just being moody and tired all the time, and you're starting to get these muscle cramps, then I would highly suggest speaking with your cardiologist about ubiquinol versus CoQ10. And if they don't know that much about it, then I would speak to another cardiologist, just do a bunch of research and just kind of formulate your own opinion on it. But in my own personal experience on working with clients and customers over the years, and actually speaking with cardiologists that actually used to come in the store a lot, they would also suggest taking ubiquinol as well. So this is just a quick hit video, guys. It's something that I really wanted to cover, because what I really love, guys, like, don't get me wrong, I love all the sexy stuff, like all the pre-workouts, the sports supplements, the branched chain amino acids, the creatines, right? I just love overall health science in general, which is kind of crazy because I'm in the finance industry and my degree is in finance. But, you know, overall health and wellness and longevity is something I'm really passionate about, and something that I'm really anal about. as well. So I absolutely love these types of questions. So if you guys have any other questions about, you know, what supplements are really good for your liver, really good for your kidney health, really good for your blood pressure, really good for, you know, your brain, I'm going to be covering up nootropics soon. You know, just drop it down in the comments down below. Even though I've been really bad with getting back to you guys in the comment section, I'm either going to try to hit all the comments down tonight and just type it in there in my phone, or I'm going to make a video just like this and I'll just answer it back to you guys and just answer it back through a video, which I think would be a lot cooler because I just love the type of relationship that I have with a lot of you guys. So, you know, drop a comment down below and I will definitely try to get back to you as fast as I can. But anyway, I love you guys. You know, stay healthy, stay safe, and I'll see you guys in the next video.